The Youth Winter Olympic Games have brought me out to Lillehammer in Norway and to this. The Hunderfossen bobsleigh track, the second largest freezer in Norway. I know, you see Norway and freezer and you think about the seed vault that's up in the Arctic, which is technically bigger than this, but this track really is one giant freezer. This track stays frozen in temperatures up to 20 degrees Celsius. So athletes can speed down here and pull 4G on the final turn, even when there really shouldn't be any ice for them to slide on.
We can keep it frozen during the summer in a normal Norwegian summer. It's built with concrete. Inside the concrete, there are lots of layers with pipes. Inside the pipes, it's running with ammonia.
When a liquid evaporates, it pulls in heat from the surrounding area. So there are 90 tons of ammonia circulating in pipes inside this freezer underneath the track, being repeatedly compressed and then evaporated to move heat away. Ammonia, by the way, really dangerous if it's not handled properly.
Because ammonia is the fastest working fluidium to drag away the warmth. All the ammonia is going inside the 65 kilometers with pipes, and it will stay inside the pipes in all conditions. If something happens and will shut down the spots that accidentally have the leaks, it's lighter than air, so it will be going upwards, so it won't be harmed.
But the laws of thermodynamics always hold true. You can't create cold, you can only ever move heat, and in the process of moving it, you generate more heat. That's why the back of your fridge at home is warm and why air conditioning units need to vent outside. And on a freezer this big, that's quite a lot of heat to move.
First thing we're doing, we are cleaning the track with the normal hoses with water. Yes, the cleaning from the summer. In the start of the season, we are running with unluge the first week. And then we start with the skeleton bob after approximately 10 days, because then the ice thickness is thick enough to compare with the bob and skeleton.
And with bobsleigh and luge runs being measured in hundredths of a second, keeping the ice consistently frozen is important for what is called competitive parity, basically making sure everyone has a fair shot. A little bit more or less friction over a day could change the result. And when there's this much riding on how fast someone goes down a track, turns out having a big freezer is really important. There's a load more videos over on the Olympics channel and on my channel. Go check them out, go subscribe, and thank you to the Youth Winter Olympic Games for bringing me out here to Lillehammer.